Hi, good evening everyone. So there's a big storm that's coming, but I had to go live anyway. The patient that I helped yesterday in ward number 145, bed number 9, there was an SOS from their side in the evening that his condition was deteriorating again, and to our huge surprise, when the doctor had a look at him, they found that the central line that was supposed to supply oxygen to him was not doing so, and he was not able to breathe, and that is why he was in distress. And because of the lack of attention from the staff, this was not even pinpointed or found earlier. So there was a delay in troubleshooting this problem, and I reached out for help from Shruti Chaturvedi, and she contacted the doctor. The problem with the oxygen supply, not only in ward number 145, in other wards, started at about 6:30 p.m. this evening. It was flagged at 6:40, and now there is a storm that's happening about, so I really don't know what the situation will be tonight, how they will put on the trays of the oxygen for the patients tonight, and I'm just keeping my fingers crossed for the lives of the people who are in GMC tonight. But I wanted to take this opportunity and really point out to people who might watch this, day in and day out, we are fighting against a system that is completely inept, and it is not responsive to the needs of the people. We are trying to do what we can with the resources that we have, but it's extremely difficult. It's extremely difficult. And if the BJP government had even an ounce of empathy, or you know, even an ounce of care for the people who have elected them to power, they would not let this happen, what is happening right now. And I guess because they are an illegitimate government, they have formed it, you know, by hijacking the MLAs of Congress party, and those people also sold themselves. So this government is actually illegitimate, and that is why I think they don't really care about the people beyond a point, because they don't really... they have not really been elected in the truest sense to power by the people. They are not a government of the people and by the people, and certainly not for the people. And it saddens my heart to see this repeat day in and day out. I am involved with the Youth Congress helpline number along with my teammates. They are amazing people who are working around the clock on the ground, working and coming to the aid of the people right now. But we can only do so much, whatever is, you know, possible in our resources. I really hope going forward people will remember this time and not forget what happened during this pandemic. It is finally not the government that has come to our aid beyond a point. It is us, you know, human beings who have come to each other's help and aid during this time. And I hope this also fosters a greater sense of brotherhood and camaraderie between everybody, especially in between religious communities. You know, the sense of divide that has been formed for political gains and political agendas, I hope that goes away and people realize that our unity and our togetherness is much more important than political gains. In the end, it's only a few people who really benefit from all of this divisiveness and our fights amongst each other. But as tragic as this pandemic has been, it has reminded us that it is indeed all of us coming to each other's help, that and that's what matters in the end. So this was an update from my side about GMC, and I really hope tonight will yet again not yield in another tragic round of deaths. I really hope and pray for the well-being of the patients in GMC. The condition there is dismal. I salute the nurses and the doctors. They are working overtime. they're under tremendous pressure, and again that is a result of the ineptness of this government and this administration. I will not blame the frontline workers at all. They're working with the resources they have. But there's a lot of food for thought for the people, and I hope people will think much more going forward. That, you know, politics is something that cannot be ignored anymore. It is a part of every, it is a part of your life from A to Z, and you just cannot ignore it anymore. Not after this.